Okay, so this is a King James moment. I'll be reading out of the Common Man's Reference Bible, and I just want to show you some of the paranoia and the information that is in the study Bible. I'll be doing different study Bibles like the Ruckman Reference Bible. I think I did a video on one of his notes. But this note is on page 1739, and he says in the footnote here, he says, "The most diabolical false brethren to infiltrate Bible-believing local churches are the Jesuit priests of Romanism. They pretend to be converts and loyal members, but they sow discord for the purpose of destruction. Other false brethren who remain outside the local assembly try to proselyte the new converts of Christ. These wolves in sheep's clothing prey on young lambs. Their main line of attack is justification by faith alone. They add works to faith." Okay, so he thinks Jesuit priests are actually infiltrating independent fundamental Baptist churches because he's an independent fundamental Baptist. They become loyal members and they sow discord. Then the other ones you have to worry about are people that are outside lurking around these local churches. And they tell people, oh, it's not by faith alone, it's by works. Watch this. If you go to page 1230 of the same study Bible, he says, "Individual salvation operated under a faith and works system during the Mosaic covenant, which is amended by the book of Hebrews for the tribulation. Under the Mosaic covenant, the individual trusts the shed blood of the sacrificial lamb and performs the works of the law in order to establish personal righteousness. When a man dies in his iniquity, he goes to hell upon death." Faith and works. He just said faith and works was the people lurking outside the church. I'm telling you guys, the paranoia, Jesuit priests coming in as loyal members. These guys actually believe this. Now, I'm not for the Jesuits at all. I know that they're evil. I know what they've done. But to take time on a little independent fundamental Baptist church, I think they got bigger fish to fry. Just saying. All right, so until next time, good day. God bless.